all done group of rural independence occur on ruin tavoctuk shot us or gore and oct. Thought she ansol ergo will fibina, August fibina ulvora. Serious concerns about the overspend on construction costs of the new National Children's Hospital. These costs, as we all know, represent an increase of 300% in the cost since the original tender. And it is shameful that the Minister for Health can't be here tonight himself. It does show the lack of respect, and I want to point that out quite clearly, the lack of respect towards rural TDs in this House. We're elected here to represent our parts of this state as well. An absolute disgrace that the Minister isn't here to hear those concerns. And I will be asking him for a direct response, because he does represent all of the state, not just Dublin. The general public have expressed concern and outrage over the fact that the current cost of construction of the National Children's Hospital stands at £1.4 billion. And this cost is rising and, as has been pointed out here tonight, will not stop at £2 billion. The project represents the most dramatic and unprecedented cost escalation level for any single health project in the history of this state, and that is some achievement. The Minister for Health is responsible for that, whether he likes it or not, and as has been pointed out here tonight, he did take his eye off the ball. He got a fixation and he had an agenda, he wanted to push that agenda, and he forgot about every other section in the health service, and we're seeing that day by day. There are serious concerns over the possibility of having a maternity hospital co-located, not having it, co-located with the National Children's Hospital as the plan now stands. The Minister or Government has not taken these concerns seriously, and it is both unfair and unacceptable that many projects in rural Ireland will now suffer the consequences brought about by this Government's arrogance and failure to acknowledge that they made serious and unacceptable mistakes in respect of the National Children's Hospital project at St James's. And even at this late stage, I would urge the Minister and indeed the Government to do the right thing, do the decent thing by the taxpayer who has borne the brunt of this terrible mistake and the reckless and unacceptable choices that this Government has made. Do the right thing by the children who need healthcare outside of Dublin. We have to ensure that they have accessible healthcare. And an independent investigation to assess the viability and cost of retendering the project and transferring its location to a greenfield site should be carried out. I believe wholeheartedly that it's the fair way to proceed, and we should not be proceeding when this has proven to be unsuccessful and detrimental. This Government has shown itself to be arrogant and has clearly said slán to proper, accessible healthcare for our children living in locations outside of Dublin. And that is outrageous and clearly shows how out of touch this Government really is. This Government not only lacks common sense, but it lacks a vision for this country.